And we're back again. Wow, what a crazy couple of days where I've had loads of stuff to get on with over the last, 2 days. So everything seems to have hit at once. So this is the last one that I've got to do until the Power Lance comes out. That was suggested by In Demand Toys that it was going to be due within the next sort of 5 to 6 weeks. Obviously, everything else has come earlier than that. So we'll just see if that comes out. The post has been removed, and I did look for it today. So I don't know if that's been delayed or if that was a mistake on their part or anything like that. I know the date isn't till later, I think November or whenever it was supposed to have been, same as a helmet or whatever. But hopefully we'll get that early. Anyway, today this is the last Ninja Ranger that we're going to see. Whether we're going to see a ninja later, I have no idea, obviously. But it would be cool just to have him there. If not, we can always use the flip head just to put him in because he scales quite well. But for now, we have got Mighty Morphin Pink Ranger, Ninja. This version is Cat. So there she is in the window. We can see her just sitting in there. You have to excuse my setting around me. I've had to move in to the bedroom just because it's the weekend. The kids are going mad. And to try and keep them away while I do this is really, really difficult. So my apologies for that. Anyway, here she is. In the box, we are seeing the same as the others. However, the biggest difference that we're, or the only difference, I suppose, that we're seeing here is the artwork on the front. So they've obviously changed it so you can see that it is Cat and it's not Kimberly and that there's a difference in the boxes and all that sort of stuff. So we've got that on the side here that's wrapping around to this side with the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers logo at the top. And then I believe, and I could be completely wrong, I don't have the box with me to double check because I store them all away in the loft. But I believe this pink at the top and the bottom is darker than on the other one. But as I say, I could be totally wrong there. So if I am, I apologise. But from what I remember, it could well be a little bit darker. And then on the side, we've got her with her hood down so we can see the face. The artwork is quite nice. Don't overly think it looks like the actress, but if they're going for like character likeness rather than actress likeness, then cool. And then we've got the render photo of the figure on the back doing a little karate kick, which looks cool. All the legal stuff on the bottom, barcode and whatever on the bottom. And that's it. And then inside we've got our figure. So there she is with her fully masked face, and then we've got the Catherine face, and then the hood up, little posing hands, and a lightning effect. And I'm going to quickly grab this open, so give me a sec just while I do that, and we will take a look at the head. So after about 5 minutes of trying to dig this out of the box, I'm finally done. So here she is. This is her full ninja form. Luckily, no wrong arms, wrong legs, nothing like that. The paint on this one looks decent, so that's cool. Obviously, we're missing the white underneath the skirt. So I think this bit's here are meant to be pink, and then in between there and at the end there, I think they're meant to be white. Can't really remember how they were, but I'm pretty sure they were. But anyway, the detail on it's really nice. Obviously, this is exactly the same as what we have seen already with Kimberly, and we're pretty much just, I say pretty much, we are just getting two different heads. I'm not sure on if this is new. So this is the effect piece that she comes with, which sits on the foot. So it slides on this one. If it does, not very well. Okay, you've got a sign kind of sliding in from the bottom. So it does fit nicely on there once you get the grip of sliding it in. And it obviously comes with that funky, painty plastic, you know, a shimmery sort of look. Don't know if it's showing it well enough on camera, but it is there. And then we get a karate chop hand and the posing. Looks to me like a grab hand, but like a little karate hand, so that's cool. She comes with the hood down sort of thing that sits on her shoulders, as well as her hood up head and mask on, which is done quite nicely, because I like that the fact that they've made the effort of putting the hair to come out of the headband at the top. I don't know if you can see that very well, if my camera is going a bit funny. But there we go. And then we have her headband head with the nice blonde hair and the headband underneath it. Yeah, and that is what it is, really. So for the figure, obviously we've got the emblem and the coin, or whatever you want to call it, in the middle. All the diamonds on there that are nicely put in, wrap around the boots, all that sort of stuff. The articulation is the same as the other pink one. The paint is the same as a pink one if you put this one and Kimberly in a full head mask next to each other. They are the same. And then there she is with her hood up and the mask on. My one is very stiff, so be a little bit careful as usual. Obviously, if it starts to be a bit stiff on the joints, and maybe heat them up or put some water on them, whatever you do. But yeah, she looks cool. There she is, posed up. So she looks decent with that. And then there she is with her last head on. Hair sits really nicely on that. I don't know if I've got this neck piece on the right way around. I can never tell which way they go, but I think it's pretty all right. But yeah, I like this. I think the face looks good. Looks like a pretty head. She looks good. I'm attracted to this figure very well, so I'm going to keep this very close. But no, she's cool. Obviously, comparing it next to Kimberly, I will bring her in. And there she... There she is next to Kat. So, Kat and Kimberly. And as you can see, everything's just exactly the same. I don't see any differences on there, obviously, apart from the head. The hands are the same, so you can see that she's even got the same sides of the hands, which obviously makes sense for Hasbro to be churning these out with the same, doubling their money on these figures. But I don't expect loads of people to be buying these. They're a very easy pass, and if you're just trying to complete the team, obviously it's going to be very easy to pass on these when you've already got Kimberly. But for completion purposes, I wanted this, so I've got it. I'm happy with it. She looks good. Looks decent. Yeah, as I said, everything's just exactly the same, minus the head. So double joints on the knees, the elbows, pinless, obviously, the articulation, everything's all the same, as well as the hands and the accessories, unless I've missed this one. But so I can't remember if this is the same or not, but... I don't use them anyway, so it's kind of irrelevant for me. But for you guys, if you're using them, it may or may not be the same, but I'm not sure. I can't find mine to get it out of the box because I've got them all in one big box, so it'll take me quite a while to dig through everything just to find it. But yeah, that's about all it is, because it's such an easy pass for people. I can imagine that these are going to be on sale very, very soon. So if you are looking for one you haven't pre-ordered, maybe hold out and see if they come. If you're looking to buy her or any of the others, you can get them on Comics and Cocktails, and they ship to most countries. I got mine from In Demand Toys in the UK, which shipped to some countries. I think they're EU countries because they don't do like US and stuff. So I think anything like France, Germany, and whatever, they do post out there. But I'm sure they'll be in targets. Fingers crossed for you guys soon, hopefully. A friend of mine in Australia said that he's been charged for some of his ninjas, so it may be that they are on the way very, very soon. Let me know in the comments if you're going to pass on her or if you're going to grab it to complete. And as I said, I can understand why you would pass on her, but for completion, I wanted it. Again, I can apologize about the background of this. Usually, I try and just do it in front of my figure so it's got a bit of something a bit more interesting there rather than just junk everywhere. So I apologize for that. If you enjoyed this video, please put a thumbs up for me. You can follow me on Instagram, it's Lightning Collector 2021, or on Twitter at Lightning C 2021. I've got a competition on my Instagram giving away a Red Ninja Rocky figure, so that'll be going. That's up until the 1st of July. I will announce the winner, so get involved with that if you haven't done already. I've also reviewed the other Ninja Rangers, which I'll leave links in the description, and I'll also leave links of where you can buy these in the description below. So if you're in the UK, you can grab it from either one. If you're in the US, you would have to use Comics and Cocktails, who do post out to the US, but it's about £30 or $30 just to get that sent over. So just bear in mind that you need to price yourself for four figures rather than three if you're going to be shipping them over. But that's enough for me anyway, guys. Hope you've all enjoyed your weekend so far, and I will see you soon, hopefully for the Blue Power Lance. And thanks for watching.